Hey, welcome. I think we're quite a few weeks into these Saturday nights, which we happened to start at the time of the lockdowns, but we had planned to start anyway, so it was a nice coinciding. But I think we talked about a few weeks ago how God actually doesn't require us to do a lot of the time. He requires us to be. And I think we lose sight of that so easily. I know for myself, I'm busy during the week. I'm running from one thing to another. And I felt God this week pull me back into his arms. It was almost like I got caught on the rat wheel, just running and spinning, and yep, I'm doing my bit, and yes, I'm engaging in my faith, and yes, I'm engaging with you, God. But actually then I felt him pull me back in and be like, hey, actually just for a minute, stop, and let's commune, let's meet. And so our prayer, my heart tonight, is that we would commune with the Lord, that we would come back, straight back to his chest as friends of God, because we're friends of God. So let's worship from that space, hey? Wherever you are, I want to encourage you just to lead yourself into a space of worship, whatever that takes for you tonight. Maybe it's just you're tuning in for a couple of seconds. Maybe you're staying with us for the full hour. Whatever it is, just for a moment, lead yourself into worship of God, because he's worthy whether we feel like it or not, whether we can hear the TV going when we're listening to worship, whether we feel goosebumps, he's worthy of it. We don't need to feel those things. He is still the same. He's still God. He's still holy and fully worthy. And we get to worship him, and he calls us into that space.
Yeah.
So welcome.
Yeah, I just feel like tonight the same thing. God just says, just let it go. Whatever has happened this week, just let it go. It's totally fine to let things go and just come before him. Probably one of the best worship lessons I ever learned was, it's not about how you're feeling or what you've done prior to when you step into worship. You know, it's just some things can't be dealt with before you step in there, and some things can. And I just feel like the Lord is saying, you know, this is a season to just trust that he will do what needs to be done, and if it doesn't happen in the way you thought it would happen, that's okay, he's still gonna do. So
amen.
Yeah,
I agree with that. And I think as well, in some ways, we can take this time of isolation and this time of lockdown, we can take it and we can run with it, because for a long time, we have relied on a structure to engage in the Holy Spirit, to engage in his presence. And now we don't have a structure, we're fully without it. And we have to find new ways to engage with him on a personal level, to see him as good, to see him as right, to see him as the God of justice, as the one true living God. We have to engage with him wholly in a personal way. And what a blessing to get to be called back into that space where I get to be outside of structure and I just get to commune with the Lord. Takes the pressure off the worship leader as well.
Never ceasing.
streams of mercy never ceasing, call for songs of loudest praise, and teach me some melodious song, sung by flaming tongues above, and praise the mountain fixed upon it, mount of
Yes, here's my heart, Lord. Take and seal it. Seal it for thy good till thou hearest. Here's my heart, Lord. Take and seal it. Seal it. All these times.
goodness is your glory. Oh, your goodness is your glory, God. Oh, your goodness is your glory. Oh, your goodness is your glory, God. Oh, your goodness is your glory. Oh, your goodness is your glory, God. Your goodness is your glory. Oh, your goodness is your glory, God. You are good, 'cause you are good,
try and be smooth. Let's do the cross.
Yeah. Do you know what? Today my brother sent me this video of his son running through these puddles and jumping in them and splashing in them. And he's in this thing and his father is laughing and he's having the best time and he's running and he just falls flat on his face in a puddle. And my brother just, you know, just laughed and he said, you're all right. And Teddy got up and he laughed and laughed and he kept jumping in puddles. And I just think it's such a beautiful illustration of God's love for us. You know, sometimes we can fall face first in a puddle and just feel like, oh, I'm such an idiot. And yet God just delights, he just delights in us. You know, the things that we don't delight in ourselves. You know, he just delights in that, and it was such a beautiful moment of just pure love and pure joy. So I just feel like if there are pursuits, if there are joys that you just feel maybe you're not skilled in, or maybe you've tried it and you'd love to be good at it, but you just can't get there, just keep jumping in the puddles. Just keep running through those fields of mud and water, and glory comes out of mud and water. We were made from clay and we were covered in his glory.
You carried the cross upon your back, bleeding until the final breath, tears of blood, the crown of thorns, you gave it all, our sins you bore. There is no greater.
The power of your love was more than enough for all.
You carried the cross upon your back, bleeding until your final breath. Tears of blood, a crown of thorns, you gave it all, our sins you bore. The sacrifice that changed history, nails in your hands, the hands that saved me. The grave was sealed, death lost its sting as the lion roared in victory. The sacrifice that changed history, nails in your hands.
was more than enough, God. More than enough, Jesus, we love you. Oh, how we love you. You are more enough. Hearts adore. Jesus, we love you. Oh,
song is called No One Ever Cared For Me Like Jesus.
Well, if my heart could tell a story, if my life would sing a song, if I have a testimony, if I have anything at all,
no one ever cared for me like Jesus. His faithful hand has held me all this way. When I'm old and gray and all my days are numbered on the earth, let it be in you alone my joy was found. His faithful hands has held me all this way. When I'm old and gray and all my days are numbered on the earth, let it be known in you alone my joy was found.
My children tell their children, oh, let this be the memory. That all my treasure was in heaven, you were everything to me. That my children, children tell the children, oh, let this be the memory. Oh, that my treasure was in heaven, and you were everything to me.
His faithful hand has held me all this way. When I'm old and gray and all my days are numbered on the earth, let it be known in you alone my joy was found.
I'm still in love.
Thanks for joining us tonight.